Good morning, children. Again, I come back with one new lesson in civics, that is urban administration. Project work: write a letter to your ward's councillor suggesting steps to improve the city in any one of the following areas: health, garbage disposal, and beautification. Children, in the last two chapters, we learnt about how villages or rural areas in India are administered. In this chapter, we will learn about administration in cities or urban areas. Children, a city is a place that is much bigger than a village in terms of size and the number of people that live in it. Usually, a city is an area where industries and modern amenities such as markets, schools, and hospitals are found in great number than in villages. The needs of people in cities and the lives they lead are also very different from that in villages. Not only needs, problems are also different. Problems like potholes in a road, a drainage channel choked with garbage, water supply, garbage disposal, etc. As a result, the nature of administration of a city is also quite different from that of a village. Depending on the population of the city, urban areas can be governed by local governing bodies known as municipal corporation, municipal council, nagar panchayat. First, we will discuss about municipal corporation. A municipal corporation is the body in charge of the administration of cities that have a population of 10 lakh or more. Big cities such as Delhi, Mumbai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Kolkata, and Chennai are governed by municipal corporation. Children, did you know our Khammam is governed by municipal corporation? Next one, elections, composition, and decision making structures. For ease of administration, cities are divided into wards. The people of each ward elect a councillor to the municipal corporation. Councillors are elected for a period of 5 years. A municipal corporation is headed by the mayor. The mayor is elected by the members of the municipal corporation from among us to themselves. The mayor chairs the meetings of the corporation. Some seats are reserved for people belonging to scheduled castes and scheduled tribes, and 1/3 of seats are reserved for women to bring social equality in the society. Members of parliament and members of the state legislative assembly from that area are also the members of the municipal corporation. Councillors form different committees to look after the manage different areas of urban administration. The commissioner is the executive officer of the municipal corporation. They implement the decisions taken by the corporation. The commissioner is appointed by the state government for a period of 5 years. Children, did you know who is your ward councillor, mayor, and commissioner? Okay, you tell me in next class. Functions. The functions of the municipal corporation are divided into two types: compulsory functions and optional functions. First, in this class we discuss about the compulsory means the main functions of the municipal corporation. The main functions of the municipal corporation are construction and maintenance of roads, bridges, public buildings, graveyards, and crematoria, supplying of clean drinking water, collection, management, and disposal of garbage, keeping the streets, sewers, public places, and the markets clean, maintaining public health and sanitation, provision of vaccination, and taking measures to control epidemics. Children, did you know we are waiting for corona vaccine? Running schools, hospitals, and dispensaries, registration of births and deaths, naming streets and numbering houses, ensuring public safety by removing obstructions and illegal buildings in public streets. Children, in next class I will discuss about optional functions. Okay, bye, thank you.